In Unity 2019.1, we've introduced UI Elements. UI Elements are a brand new way of building high-performance and scalable UI for your projects and act as an alternative to the existing Immediate Mode GUI, also known as IMGUI. With UI Elements, we separated the user interface logic, hierarchy, and styling into three individual components. In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can use the new UI Elements framework to customize the look of an inspector inside of the editor. As you can see here, we have an empty room that's waiting to be filled with props. Using UI Elements, I've built a custom inspector here that displays a list of buttons for each available prop. Each button shows a preview window of the asset and a label with the name for the prop. If we click on the button, the prop spawns into our environment, ready to be moved into place. Let's take a look at how this inspector was built. If we go to the Scripts folder, we have our Prop Spawner script. This is the mono behavior attached to our props game object in the hierarchy. If we then open the editor folder, we can see three files related to our UI. The first, our prop spawner editor script, is just like a usual C# editor script. As you can see, if we open the script, it inherits from the editor and is a custom editor of our prop spawner script. The second script is our prop spawner template asset. This is a Unity-defined XML hierarchy asset known as UXML and acts as the base for our UI's hierarchy. If we open the asset, we can see a series of nested rows of XML. The hierarchy is reflected in the preview of the inspector when we have the asset selected. The final asset is our prop spawner styles asset. This is written in a strict subset of CSS known as USS. This asset defines how each element in our UXML document looks. For instance, you can see here that each button in our UXML file has the prefab button class added. Our USS file contains a reference to this class to tell the button how it should be styled. Now let's take a look at how we use this data to draw the UI in our editor script. Unlike IMGUI, UI Elements is a retained mode API, which means that the state is retained between the draw frames of the editor. This means that we aren't forced to repaint our UI every frame if we don't want to. Instead, we can simply build our UI when the script is enabled and make changes when we require them. To start drawing our UI, we first create a visual element. This is the base class for elements in UI Elements. We then load our UXML asset as a visual tree asset. We'll use this to create an in-memory UI hierarchy of our visual elements by cloning the tree. We then create a style sheet by loading our USS. We then add the style sheet to our visual elements to apply our styles to it and all its child elements. The editor class now includes a createInspectorGUI method that we override and return a visual element to draw. We use uQuery to find elements in our UI hierarchy and bind functionality to them or augment them with more C# created elements. In this instance, I'm iterating through our buttons and adding the icon for the prefab to the button. This uses our IMGUI container, which is a way to draw IMGUI UI inside UI Elements. Finally, I'm registering a mouse down callback on the button element to tell it to spawn the prefab when clicked. By separating out the styling and hierarchy of the UI from the functional logic, we can create a much more streamlined workflow for our UI content. It's fast and easy to make changes to how our UI looks by simply editing our data assets. Let's add a header to our spawn tool. Let's go back to our UXML and add a new row. We can use the label tag to create text labels inside of the UXML element. Let's add some text. For example, choose a game object to spawn. Then we'll define a new style class called header. If we now go back into Unity and look in our inspector, we can see that our custom editor has been updated with our new header element. Now let's go to our style sheet and add an entry for the header style class. Let's set the font size to 15 pixels and the color to yellow. And as you can see, our header is updated to match this new style. Finally, as we build our UI, we may want to figure out how our data is being handled and drawn. we can use the UIElements debugger window to do this. The UIElements debugger window can be found in Window, Analysis, UIElements Debugger. This window allows us to inspect the hierarchy of each of our elements. We can use the Pick Element button to hover over any of the editor elements to inspect their current visual hierarchy. We can also see the style classes and style properties of each element. If we wanted to preview how an element might look with different style properties, we can simply modify the value in the window. As you can see, UIElements will make it easy to build and work with UI in Unity across large teams. UIElements is currently available in Unity 2019.1 for overriding inspectors in the editor and for creating custom editor windows. Further support, including in-game UI, is coming in the future. So, if you'd like to explore how to build with UIElements and see what you can do, grab the free example project that's linked in the description below and give it a try. Thanks for watching.